हाई फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज विठल पंद्रे, फैकल्टी ऑफ जुआलजी, तेलंगाना ट्राइबल वेलफेयर रेजिडेंशियल डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर मेन, बोथेट आदिलाबाद। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज ब्लड सर्कुलेशन। ब्लड सर्कुलेशन इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इन ह्यूमन बॉडी। इट इज ए वेल डेवलप्ड एनिमल्स एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स एनिमल्स, ऑल एनिमल्स आर हैविंग द सर्कुलर सिस्टम। The cell system also maintains the uniformity of the internal of body. So, circulatory system is most developed in human beings. The circulatory system responsible for transporting materials throughout the entire body. It transports nutrients, water, and oxygen to billions of body cells. And carry away waste such as carbon dioxide that body cells produce. It is an amazing highway that travels through entire body, connecting our body cells. The system is especially main organ is heart. It has some components. The system is have components. That components are heart, blood, and vessels. The heart, it is a pumping organ in the body. Blood is a fluid connective tissue. It is a red river of the life. And arteries, vessels are three types: arteries, veins, and capillaries. Which gases are transported to form the body's cells by the blood flowing the circulatory system. The oxygen is the gas needed for respiration and transported to the body cells. So most here O2 level blood and CO2 level blood both are there here. The circulatory system carries two types of blood: oxygenated blood, which is the red in color, and deoxygenated blood or CO2 level blood, that which is blue in color. The blood traveling to the body cells and high oxygen content is there in the O2 level blood and very less CO2 content is there. In the same way, in the CO2 level blood, the blood traveling away from the body cells and O2 level are very less, so low oxygen content and high carbon dioxide content is there. Arrangement of the circulatory system means that these two types of blood do not mix. The heart is the organ, main organ. At the center of the circulatory system, it pumps blood around the body. The heart is located in the left side of the body. The inside the heart is divided into two sections, so that the two types of blood, oxygen rich and oxygen poor, O2 level blood and CO2 level blood, both are there here. Right side of the heart, oxygen poor, and left side of the heart, O2 level more. The heart structure. Generally, heart structure, it is covered by two layer membrane, that is called pericardium. The pericardium covers the heart and large blood vessels attached to the heart. Visceral pericardium also there, innermost layer and directly on the heart. Parietal pericardium also there, that is the layer on top of the visceral pericardium. These pericardium filled with a fluid. The fluid is called pericardium fluid. It protects the heart from the shocks, especially heart walls, epicardium, myocardium, and endocardium. Epicardium, outermost layer, and fat cushion heart. Myocardium is a middle layer, and endocardium is a innermost layer. The middle layer primarily cardiac muscle, and inner layer it is a stretches as the heart pore. You may observe the heart. Generally, heart location in our left side, human body left side, and it is a pear shaped or fist. It is protection by the rib cage and backside vertebral column is there. Generally, heart triangle outline is the triangle. Anterior is the wider and posterior is the narrower. It has four chambers are there. The heart is myocardium. the most majil heart and strong and thick composed of spontaneously contracting and cardiac majil fibrils. Can conduct electricity like nerves. Its blood supply comes from the coronary arteries. These coronary arteries is most important. Why? Because heart attack reason this coronary arteries. When the block of coronary artery, the human being face a problem. The problem is called heart attack. Outer structure of the heart. And now inner structure, the chambers are, four chambers are there. Upper parts are auricles or atrium. Downwards are, lower chambers are called ventricles. Right and left, right and left. Here, two atria or auricles divided by one septa. Right atrium and right left atrium. Right and left. Auricles or atrium. Atria means plural. So, atria divided by one septa. The septa is called interauricular septum. These two auricles are divided by one auricle. It means septum. The septum name is interauricular septum. At the same time, ventricle also divided by septa. The interventricular septum. Here, auricles interauricular septum and downwards ventricle interventricular septum. These are the septum divided by auricles, auricle, left and right. At the same time, ventricle, left and right. And also, auricle and ventricles also divided by one septa. That is, auriculoventricular septum. Left means left auriculoventricular septum. Right means right auriculoventricular septum. This septum has some walls. The walls, it means the cover, the aperture. The aperture location is the left and right auriculoventricular septum. That is the aperture. The aperture covered by some walls. Left and right. Generally, left auricle is smaller than right atrium. And left ventricle larger than right ventricle. Generally, atrium and ventricles, the ventricles walls are very thick and auricles or atrium walls are very thin. Why? Because the ventricles pump the blood throughout the body. That's why the ventricles walls are very thick. At the same time, left side, both the left side, it means left atrium or atria and left ventricle, these two walls are very thick. Why? Because here, O2 level blood flowing in the left side. Why? These atrium or ventricle completely pumps the blood throughout the body, even fingers and lower downs also. That's why these are the very most important. Ventricles, it will completely, it possess or pumps the blood only lungs. That's why ventricles left side thick, left side, right side small. Here blood flowing. The ventricles pump blood out of the body. It means heart, sorry. Atria collects from totally all the body parts. The chambers of the heart have different functions. The heart structure. See, the walls between the atria and ventricles are connected to the inner walls of the heart by tough tendons. Not only tendons here, cardiac tendinae also there. Cardiac tendinae between the walls. Walls are very powerful, very useful in the blood circulation. Here are some open and wall and open here down. Both are there here. You may see here very clearly the tendon allows the walls to close and hold the walls flap in place. They prevent the walls from flipping up, turning inside out. Here, wall open, you may observe very clearly, and valve close. This is the door level type or arm level. Our hand can't come backside. So it is only one way direction. The walls also very useful in the blood circulation, especially in the heart. Only one direction. Door can't come reversely. Only one side. That's why it's called one direction of the. Next, the wall acts like the, as I said now only. See here, if the door is held by someone at a fixed point, only the arm moves as the door opens and closes. When the door is closed, the arm is fully extended, so they can only be opened in one direction. The valves can't give backside flow of the blood. The heart can pump blood because it is made up of muscles. We know that muscles are more powerful, cardiac muscle. Muscle tissue works by contracting, squeezing and relaxing. How does heart pump blood? All the parts of the heart on either side working together in repeated sequence. The two atria contract and relax, then the two ventricles contract and relax. Both are there. This is how blood moves through the heart and is pumped to the lungs and the body. One complete sequence of contraction and relaxation is called heartbeat. Nothing but here, cardiac cycle. Generally, in the blood circulation, blood vessels play a major role. Arteries, capillaries, and veins. There are three types of blood vessels. Arteries, these are the large vessels carry blood from heart to tissue of the body and carry oxygen rich blood with the exception pulmonary arteries. Thick walls are there, need to withstand pressure produced when heart pushes blood into them. And capillaries, these are the very microscopic blood vessels. These are the continuity between the arteries and veins. Walls are only one cell thick and very narrow. Important for bringing nutrients and oxygen, tissues and absorbing carbon dioxide and other waste products. Generally, we eat solids, we drink liquids and we breathe gases. So nutrients and carbon dioxide are nothing but air and water. These are the we are drinking, eating and breathing. Veins. Once blood has passed through the capillary system, it must be returned to the heart. Done by veins, walls contain connective tissue and smooth muscle. Largest vein contain one-way valves that keep blood flowing towards heart. Many found near skeletal muscles, when muscles contract, blood is forced through veins. See here, once artery and veins are differences very super is there here, artery inside part endothelium, here also there, both are capillary is the common blood vessels in the artery and in the vein. So artery, generally walls are absent in the arteries. You may see observe here, upper part here, walls are present in the veins. Arteries, walls are very thick. Why? Because completely blood flowing through the artery only. Veins, walls are very thin. The lumen of vessel in the artery very large. In the vein, the lumen is very small. The elastic position is very high in the artery. The elastic position very less in the vein. Artery carries only O2 level blood. Means oxygenated blood it carries. Except pulmonary artery. That is CO2 level. At the same time, generally veins are carrying deoxygenated blood. It means CO2 level blood, except pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein carries the O2 level blood. If blood is absent in the artery can't, nothing will happen. But when the blood is absent in the vein, it will collapse. Dead people, we will observe, veins are collapsed. Bluish color will come outside. These are the arteries and veins. Now I will explain the how functioning of the heart. Here, heart functioning. You may observe here very clearly. Lungs, right atrium, right ventricle, and left atrium and left ventricle. You may observe here generally veins carry the blood from the body parts. Pre-caval vein, you may hear one, and post-caval vein and pulmonary vein. Pre-caval vein, post-caval vein and pulmonary vein, these are the pulmonary vein only from the lungs, it will carry the blood. At the same time, pre-caval vein and post-caval vein, it will carry body part. Especially pre-caval vein, it will collect the blood from the Pre, it means superior vena cava, also called as superior vena cava. Post cava means inferior vena cava. Upper parts and lower parts, head, stomach, and post cava means legs, like that. Carries and giving, pumping the blood into the right atrium, here, right atrium. At the same time, pulmonary vein from the lungs, it will sending or pumping the blood in the left atrium. At that time, both the atria or auricles contraction. Right atrium and left atrium, both are at a time, they are contraction. At that time, auricles are contraction and blood pumping or sending into the ventricle. In the left auricle and left ventricle, at the same time, right auricle or atrium, right ventricle, there are some valves are there. Here the valves, bicuspid wall and here tricuspid wall. Tricuspid wall, it has three cusps and bicuspid only two cups. These walls are aperture between the left atrium and left ventricle aperture. That aperture covered by walls. That walls can't give backside the movement. That time, one small sharp sound will come. The sharp sound is called lab, nothing but systole. Afterwards, it will enter into the blood into ventricles. So ventricles, when contraction, the ventricles is pumping the blood in the aorta. One time here systemic aorta, systemic aorta, and second one here pulmonary aorta. Both are there. At that time, the blood pumping into the arteries, it will give completely all the body parts and collecting the by some precall vein. So that time, very small, it means very dull sound will come. The dull sound means dub, lub and dub. That time completely is a cycle, the heartbeat or cardiac cycle will come. Auricles or atrium contraction, it will take simply 0.11 to 0.14 seconds only. At the same time, ventricles needed for time 0.27 to 0.35 seconds. One contraction relaxation of the auricles and ventricles, it will take approximately 8 seconds. That is called cardiac cycle. Here, cycle is formed phases, two phases, active phase and one is inactive phase. It means dull phase. Active phase is called systole and inactive phase is called diastole. One systole, one diastole, it is called cardiac cycle or heartbeat. This is the circulation. So here you observe one thing here, lungs, it is a refresher. CO2 level blood coming from pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein collecting from the lungs. In that refreshment, it freshness O2, CO2 here, blood level, O2, CO2, hemoglobin, oxyhemoglobin, all going the process in the lungs only. So lungs are majorly play a major role in the circulation. So here blood coming two times to the heart. That's why it is called double circulation. The circulation is here, double circulation. Why? Because two times. One is left atrium one time and left atrium second time. The arrow marks of red color are the completely O2 level blood. Arrow marks blue color, that is completely CO2 level blood. This is the left side body, completely oxygenated blood is going on, and right side of the completely CO2 level blood. Blue is in red color, this side reddish in color, circulate. Here major aorta is the systemic aorta. This is the systemic aorta, it completely. Systemic aorta is majorly this one, major systemic aorta. And large, smallest artery is the pulmonary artery, this one. Smallest and this is the largest. It will only right ventricle and right atrium are very major role is not there. Why? Because they are sending blood only lungs. Lungs are very near to the heart. But systemic aorta pumping the blood throughout the body. Ventricles proper. Ventricles, all the body parts, even toes, fingers, eyes, nose, all the body parts it will send. That's why these walls are very thick. This is the completely blood circulation. Now I will explain blood. Blood is a fluid connective tissue. It is a red river of life. Blood plays a major role in the circulation. It is composed of plasma and blood cell. Plasma, we know that it is a straw colored and 90% of water is there. 10% dissolved gases, salt, nutrients, enzymes, hormones, and waste material and proteins. All are in the plasma only. Next, blood cells. Blood cells there are three types. One is red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. White blood cells. These are the guard against infection, right to parasites and attack bacteria, and number of WBCs increase when body is fighting. Lymphocytes produce antibodies, thick fight pathogens and remember them. Platelets, these are also aid the body in the clotting. Small fragments stick to the edges of broken blood cell and secretes clotting factor to help from clot. Blood plasma. Here three types of albumins, globulins and fibrinogen. Albumins and globulins are helpful in the transport of substances such as fatty acids, hormones and vitamins. But fibrinogen, it is most important and responsible for the blood clotting ability, coagulation purpose. Red blood cells, red blood corpuscles or RBC cells. Most numerous type transport oxygen, get color from hemoglobin, disc shaped, made in red bone marrow, and it will circulate for 120 days, lifespan of 120 days. Red blood cells, the formation of RBCs is called erythropoiesis. The red blood cells are especially, it is from bone marrow, it is completely erases or formation from the bone marrow. After collapse, it means circulation, it means the lifespan 120 days, they will go to the spleen and liver. That's why spleen is called graveyard of RBCs. Next, WBC. Here we know that WBC, here two types. One is especially WBC granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes, which granule have in their cytoplasm, that is called granulocyte. Which have no granule, that is called agranulocytes. Nothing but leukocyte. White blood cells, nothing but leukocyte. WBC, the granulocytes again, here three types. One is acidophils, second one basophils, and third one neutrophils. Basophils, acidophils, neutrophils, based on their stain dyes. Pigment are nothing but colored. Acidophils means they have only acid level, that's why it is called acidophils. The loops are only one or two loops are there. The cytoplasm has so many granules and they destroy the engulf the foreign materials from the body. Next one, basophils. Base, it means which stained by base dye, that's why they are called basophils. It is a loops here, S type. It means two or three loops are there, that is S type nucleus, and cytoplasm is very clear. This also, bacteria and viruses are any harmful material when enter into the blood cells, these WBC, especially these cells are sending outside. Next, neutrophils. It has not acid and there is no base. So they are neutro dyes are there here. These are completely, any virus or bacteria coming, they are occupying and destroying that material from outside. That's why the neutrophils are called microscopic policeman in the WBC. These three are white blood cells, especially granulocytes. Next one, agranulocytes, which have no granules in their blood level. That's why they are called agranulocytes. These are two types. One is lymphocyte and other one is monocyte. Lymphocyte, they have no granules, they have no loops, only nucleus is round or oval in shape. Granules are absent. In the cytoplasm, they are also most play a major role in the AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, that virus can destroy the lymphocytes. They're also preparing own antigens and antibodies against the foreign material in the blood level. These are the smallest cells in the white blood cells. Lymphocytes are very small cells. Next one, monocytes. Monocytes are largest cells in the WBC. The monocytes, the nucleus is kidney shaped. It has no any type of granules. In the cytoplasm, when any foreign material entering into the blood, it will destroy or engulf and sending. Especially monocytes damage due to blood cancer, especially leukemia. That is called here blood level. Finally, blood has three main functions. Not only three, there are so many there. Transportation, protection, and temperature and regulation. The foreign materials, it will helping the blood, all the body parts, digest food material or waste material, digest food material, sending all the tissues. And protection, it will protect from the any shocks or any viruses or any bacterias. And it regulation very temperature level also. And hormones also sending one place to other place. When the body cutted any harmful or needle, at that time coagulation also very useful, this blood, especially platelets. It has no nucleus, but cytoplasm is there. In that nucleus, in the platelets, the coagulation process, prothrombin or fibrinogen, like these enzymes are there in the platelets and especially blood. That's why blood is play a major role. The study of blood is called hematology. This is the circulatory system. Thank you very much.